All right, good morning, everyone. How are you? This is so exciting to be here. I'm Dr. Heather, and I'm the doTERRA employee clinic physician, and I'm talking to you here from Pleasant Grove at our beautiful doTERRA campus, and soon to be our newest medical facility for the Prime Meridian Health Complex across the street that's going to be opening in just about a month. So I'm really excited about that. So today we're going to talk a little bit about a mental detox. And what is a mental detox? I hadn't really even heard that term until I was asked to present for this, but I love it. And it's something I believe I've done, I've tried to do. And I hopefully will have some ideas based on my own personal experience and then what I see in my clinic as a family physician every day. Data has shown that in the last 40 years, we have been bombarded. Our brains have been bombarded with more information on a daily basis, even in an hourly basis, than at any time during history. When all of these thoughts and images are constantly barraging us, our minds and our thoughts get overloaded. Our bodies get overloaded. Our spirits can get overloaded. And these thoughts are assaulting us. It can send our brain mixed messages, and then our brain tries to process, and it can be confusing. But we do know that the increased amount of input that we get to our brains and to our body and to our eyes and how it's received can be hyperstimulating. There's a book called Margin, and it talks about, in the back, there's graphs. I don't know how it shows up on the screen, but basically since the 70s, 60s and 70s, everything is like this. Whatever, you can name it. How many cereal choices you have, how many butter choices you have, how many choices you have, how many different shopping experiences you want, how many now internet browsers, movies, anything you want. It is all going up like this. And what is that? There's so many different factors, but hopefully today we'll talk about a few factors that mentally we can help downshift our mind a little bit, and hopefully it'll be some benefit, and these beautiful oils that we have can definitely help enhance that. So I found a reference that is really a good comparison, I think, to what happens in our bodies. So our environment frequently goes through detox. And in traditional medicine, Western medicine, the term detox is very vague. It's not really a scientific medical term. So if you talk with your colleagues about it, when I do as a physician, it's not, what does that mean, right? Well, physiologically, it means what your liver and your kidney do, right? Your liver processes contaminants, processes any kind of biochemicals that your body might produce or bring into your body. And this can be part of our cleansing process. And we also know what happens when we put too much in. You can get liver disease. You can get fatty liver from what's happening with our diet. You can get cancer, lots of those things. And then we also have the filtering mechanism through the kidney, right? So then it gets processed through the blood. Then the kidney helps filter out. Huge responsibilities for these organs. Well, our environment does the same thing. So the reference that I found talked about our environment goes through detox sessions, much like our body, like lightning, rain, snow. It basically comes down and helps detox our environments. This lightning and rain produce ions that actually bring these ions closer to Earth. And these ions are attracted to atmospheric contaminants, which are then either grounded or oxidized. So I like this comparison. In other words, lightning and rain don't try to hide from the contaminants. They don't make a huge effort to analyze the contaminants and try to figure out how to get rid of them. They just do their thing. And so mental detox can be somewhat like that. So we've talked a little bit about physical detox, about environmental detox, but what can we just do to bring in a life-affirming, healing, health-affirming way of calming our brain down, which we know there's a body-brain connection and can maybe even help with healing our bodies. And just bring in positive thoughts into your environment and possibly changing these scripts that run through your brain. So how do I cleanse these negative thoughts and habits for my life? What are the things that I've done personally as a woman and as a physician, maybe to help with my patients as well? So I love this comparison. My dad's a child psychiatrist and he's phenomenal. He's one of my heroes and he relates with kids. He connects with them. He just has a bond with them. And one thing he talks a lot about is these scripts that are running through our brains. And a comparison of these scripts would be like the pioneers who've come across the country and you know those ruts that they leave in the dirt, like those old wooden wheels leave those ruts. I mean, you can still see them now. And when something happens, when we get input, what does our brain do? It just, boom, falls right into that rut and just goes along. And I love that visual because that's what happens. As some of our experiences, as some of our input, our brain will just drop into that rut. And I feel that a mental detox is a way of pulling it out of that rut and getting you maybe on fresh ground, on different ground. So what kinds of things can we do? Number one, I like the Nike motto, if I'm even allowed to say it, just do it, right? Just do something. Anything to get out of what you are currently doing. Meaning, doesn't mean you're running away. It doesn't mean you're quitting your job. You are just changing that environment that you're in right now, especially if the thoughts and the input is just too much. That may be a 10-minute walk. That may be walking your dog. That may be, if you can't get out of your office like I can't sometimes, getting a video on and doing a 10-minute series of Pilates stretches or yoga stretches, something to get out of myself. And in doing that, data has shown that your brain, oh, guess what? Maybe I can start repositioning what I'm doing, just the act of doing something. Being like a new mom and being just doing the same thing over and over again. Is there something that you can do when you're in a mindset of doing the same thing where you pick up and just change a focus? I know it sounds really basic, but it's still something we got to talk to our brains about. And so I like this. This is the science side of it. Your frontal lobe, this one here, right, is responsible for a lot of your thoughts, emotions. Of course, other parts of your brains are, but how you relate with the world. And when it's not moving or when it's down, it's not being activated like it needs to be. Well, what's happening nowadays? Everyone's like this, right? What's our frontal lobe doing? It's down here, or we're like this. And what is that doing? It's not activating our frontal lobe. And so I had once worked with a neurological chiropractor who talked a lot about pulling that frontal lobe up and what that does. Look at patients with Parkinson's or people with disabilities. They're starting to slouch forward, and being able to pull up that frontal lobe can make a huge difference. So what do we do when we're walking, when we're doing yoga, when we're doing stretches, when we're doing any kind of exercise? Pulling ourselves up helps activate our frontal lobe, and that can help retrain your brain. So I do medical acupuncture, and there is a frontal lobe activation treatment that I do, and it can be very effective for people kind of coming out of being inside their box or being on their rut, and combining that with movement can be effective. Another great thing to do is to hug. This is so great if it's allowed in your environment, but hugging is a great thing. The data has shown that hugging actually increases your levels of dopamine, serotonin, oxytocin, neurotransmitters. These are feel-good neurotransmitters. They promote feelings of contentment, reduce anxiety and stress. So the act of connecting with someone, and I was once at a conference where we talked about connecting heart to heart. I just thought that was interesting that in some cultures, that's what is done. All right, number two, spend your mental energy, right? The energy that's spinning around on things you can control. And, you know, you've probably heard this term, it is what it is. And that's really true, right? What can we truly control? I'm trying to talk to my newly teenage twins about that. Like what we can control in this minute, what we can't control from the past, and what we can't control in terms of our fear for the future, right? We don't want to get these emotions all bottled up and with the fear and the worry because we can't control something. Taking a deep breath, and we'll talk a little bit about the breathing, can help with that control aspect. So how do you help with releasing some of that control. And along with that, a lot of times forgiveness is involved. There's a lot of issues that we may not be able to release mentally because of a seed of unforgiveness, a seed of resentment. My husband always tells me this famous Amos quote about acid does more on the article in which it's stored than on that which it's poured. So think about it. You're storing all that acid, and people actually get stressed out with stomach ulcers, right? And increased stomach acid. But you're storing all that anger and rage or whatever the issue is. And you might have anger and rage pouring on other people, but the more you store it, the more damage it's going to do to you. And you may not even have a person in your life currently, but someone that there's still a lot of resentment and forgiveness issues you need to deal with, that it's still burning you up and they may not even realize it. So talking about forgiveness is something, and we'll relate that with our oils too. So how do you pull out some of these thoughts? Active journaling. And that's been a huge component in my life. And I've saved all my journals. And the actual act of taking a pen to paper does something different to your brain. Talking about my awesome dad again, he's been a journaler for many, many years, and he's been my inspiration. And he started for a while journaling on his iPad and noticing it just wasn't having the same effect. And then he came across some psychological data that talked about journaling, writing something down, and just focusing on that pen and paper, that changes the brain connection. And you're getting these thoughts out onto paper. And it can be in whatever form you want, whether it's a letter. I do it like a prayer meditation, and just getting out what the thoughts are. And it can be incredibly cleansing and incredibly detoxing. And I use oils to help support me in that. So we can talk about that. And the really neat thing is keeping the journals and looking back at them and going, and this is a nice thing about being old, which I'm getting definitely, is looking back and going, wow, that what I was so anxious about or so stressed about or really was obsessed in my life about, look at what's happened now. You know, things worked out fine. There may have been a trauma. There may have been a crisis, but you can see how things were worked out for me. It may be answered prayer, but you can look back and there's a physical something to look back on. And I think there's that connection, which helps reset our brain focus. And then finally, number three, I would say is breathe. This is such a critical component of life. And you probably, if any of you have the watches that say, breathe, you need to breathe now, which kind of drives me up the wall. But actually the act of breathing, which yoga is a big part of, can reset your brain chemistry. And some data suggests that just doing 5 deep abdominal breaths, bringing in the breath through your abdomen, and I always tell my patients to feel like you're blowing up a balloon through your abdomen, not this, but more, don't use your chest, just breathe through your belly. 5 deep breaths, 5 seconds in, 5 seconds out. And there's varying types of breathing, whether it's in through your nose, out through your mouth, in through your nose, out through your nose, different types of it. But the act of doing that slow breathing can actually prevent panic attacks. If you feel a panic attack is coming on, closing your eyes and doing that deep breath can actually physiologically prevent it. Our body needs oxygen. In the environments we're in now, I talk to my patients a lot about sitting. And one of the slogans out there is sitting is the new smoking. I'm sitting, I know, right now. But we're sitting for 8 to 12 hours a day nowadays. Didn't used to be that way. And so in the sitting, our diaphragm's compressed. I'm going to start shrinking down. My shoulder's compressed. My neck's compressed. My frontal lobe is down. And what does that do to our breath, right? It decreases our lung capacity and how well we breathe. And of course, we have environmental factors that affect your breathing. So a great way to do mental detox is also to breathe. So let's tie in the 3 points that I just talked about with essential oils, some of my favorite. So what I wanted to talk about was my first one, right? So the just do it, the go, do something. I love a lot of our blends, but I fall in love with Arise. So that's the yoga, one of the yoga blends. And if you look at the science blog behind Arise, it's totally ties into what we're talking about. So they created this Arise blend with doTERRA scientists and the yoga specialist, Elena Brower, and it helps calm the mind, energize the body. And I have it diffusing right now. I love it in the morning and throughout the day, depending on what is going on. So one of the things they talk about are emotions are a complex sum of the activity of multiple systems in the brain and body, right? Think to a day when you had a lot on your mind, but just a few hours of sleep to get you through everything. Your central nervous system was agitated, it was stressed, but your peripheral nervous system, right? The extremities and legs and feet probably felt sluggish and struggled to keep up. So a single stimulus can affect multiple body systems. So this is why they put together this particular blend. So the oils in the Arise Enlightening blend, so that's the other name for it is Enlightening, were chosen to create a blend with a beautiful aroma and powerful biological effects. So what do they have in it? Lemon, grapefruit, so the citruses, Siberian fir, osmanthus, melissa, and fractionated coconut oil. So the main constituents in it are the limonenes, the beta pinenes, alpha pinenes, borneol acetate, and gamma terpenine. So what do we know about the lemon and grapefruit? Right? They're known for their energizing properties. They have the high limonene content. In one study they referenced, researchers found physiological parameters related to energy and arousal were significantly increased following the inhalation of the oil. And another study found inhalation of limonene alone is sufficient to enhance alertness and other measures of bodily arousal. So again, brain, lots of mental energy. Let's just get up and do something. Maybe we consider Arise, right? Siberian fir is also in it. But it's rich in alpha pinene, beta pinene, and borneol acetate, and they work by different mechanisms to calm and uplift the mind. And one study actually used an EEG, which is looking at your brain activity, to show alpha pinene enhances the quality and duration of sleep, of deep sleep. So it calms the mind by relaxing the autonomic nervous system, which is your nervous system that's the unconscious activity. So maybe feelings of tension that we experience but can't control are usually linked to this division of the nervous system. So combining now the citrus and the Siberian fir can act on the autonomic nervous system, the CNS, in different ways. It also promotes feelings of happiness, so that is an encouraging. And then osmanthus, melissa are floral oils. So these include ketones, esters, ethers, alcohols, and aldehydes. And this contributes to the unique composition of it. It can be used without, with or without dilution during your morning routine, during times of stress, during yoga, or during some kind of exercise or workout to give it a unique combination of invigoration and relaxation. So they have a great reference online about from their science blog and from their chemical constituents, so something to look up. And along with that, you do have two other yoga oils, the Align and the Anchor blend. So if anybody's interested in those. And I do talk about people using those topically in different areas, whether it's on your pulse points that I've talked about with acupuncture points on the inside of the elbow, it's heart three. And some of those points can be very effective with when used with the oils on the bottom of the feet, perhaps on the reflex points that are for the heart and lungs, which is more autonomic nervous system, or on the big toe, which is more of the brain. And though that goes along with the other couple of oils that I'm going to talk about. So the second oil is Forgive. I can show you my product information page, right? Or my oils, which are here. I didn't even show you them. So right, Arise is in the little bottle, Forgive's in a little bottle. And then I'll talk about my third one. So I love Forgive. First of all, I love the emotional aromatherapy blends. I've talked about them before because I had been using a lot of oils prior to the doTERRA coming out with emotional aromatherapy blends, and they're phenomenal. But I love that they put the six oils in this emotional wheel and that you can use it strategically in different seasons of your life or throughout the day. But why is Forgive important? Well, what was the second point we talked about was forgiveness or release, getting those emotions out of your brain, right? So MD Anderson in Phoenix, which is an integrative medicine cancer institute, and this was presented at our convention a few years ago, talked about using the Forgive blend and how remarkable it was over a 9-month study to help with feelings of happiness, improved job satisfaction, improved productivity on the job, decreased feelings of sadness and frustration. that's pretty nice. And so using that in all ages, because we have the forgive touch, and I'm finding that with my teenagers that I need to use quite a bit of this for myself as well. But using this as a way to help downshift and to help get into a mind of, okay, I'm going to start letting go. So I'm going to just read a little bit about our forgive blend. It may offer an organic aid for overcoming a negative past and pressing forward into a bright future. I like that. Overcoming difficult experiences, relationships, or feelings. And your body is doing this as you're writing this out, as you're journaling it. So what do we have in forgive? We have spruce, bergamot, juniper berry, myrrh, resin, arborvitae, nutka tree, thyme, and citronella. So it uses a combination of these tree and herb oils. And what does this give you? A high concentration of monoterpene esters and alcohols, which can help balance emotions in certain areas of the brain in circumstances of frustration and stress. And like we talked about, where you could put them in the same place as we talked about with the Arise blend. So I like the uses and benefits. Again, promotes feelings of contentment, relief, and patience. If you're striving to feel these grounding emotions in your life, apply them to your pulse point and heart throughout the day. Making time to meditate with the doTERRA Forgive Blend to reduce negative emotions. So talking about meditation, journaling, maybe if you're doing a yoga practice or some kind of stretches, you can be diffusing it or, again, topically applying it. And then if you maybe have an encounter or a meeting or something with someone or discussion with your kids that you might need to work with, perhaps putting this on ahead of time. And I've definitely been known to sneak it up on my kids throughout the day. On the pulse points, the base of the skull has this point right behind the greater occipital protuberance and behind the mastoid process. That's almost like a direct access into the brainstem, which can help calm. So another wonderful oil, forgive, love it. Consider that. And then number three, in terms of oils to help with mental detox for myself, is vetiver. I absolutely love vetiver. There's a couple of personal reasons why. And then I'll talk to you a little bit about how I've used it for myself and clinically. So vetiver comes from Haiti. If any of you have not seen the Healing Hands or the co-impact sourcing videos from doTERRA of the vetiver sourcing in Haiti, try to watch it. It is phenomenal because the vetiver root is this thick tangle of roots in the ground, and these roots grow downward. And so it just, they're adherent to the ground. And this root is the origin of this essential oil. And Haiti is one of the main places in the world that has it. And it's this earthy, very strong aroma, but it has been used throughout the world in perfumes. And it's composed of multiple sesquiterpenes. It has this very grounding effect. So what I love is, A, I've done a lot of medical missions to Haiti. Both my husband and I have. And whenever I smell it, I think of the times that I've spent there. I've worked in some really, really challenging situations there. And the people there are so resilient, like these roots. And so that brings me back to a special place in my memory when I use it. But if you look at what the root, what does the oil do? A lot of times these beautiful essential oils do what the plant itself does. So vetiver is a very grounding, solid root. And this is what it can do for our emotions. So there are some studies on if people have issues with focus, that vetiver can be very effective to help with focus and attention. Vetiver can be helpful with sedation, with calming, perhaps with any sleeping issues. And that's what the root itself does. It pulls you back to earth. It pulls you to the ground, right? And again, I feel like watching those videos really helps me. The Haitian people just pulling that vetiver out and the intensity that goes into that process. So how do I use it? I have always used it at night since I first discovered it, and just helps me refocus at the end of the day, along with deep breathing. So 5 deep breaths, right? And cupping it over your nose, breathing in through your nose slowly. And what I love about it is it helps me downshift, because I will literally lay on my back. And if anybody knows child's pose or happy baby pose, where you can kind of have your feet up next to you, I will turn the vetiver bottle, and it takes a while. It's like molasses. So it takes a while to come out, but I will just, that time of watching it drip out and slowly go onto my big toe, my brain, and to massage it in and on the ball of my foot on the autonomic nervous system and breathing during that, that is a downshifting time for me. And that helps with what we talked about with the breathing. Helps me refocus, get ready for bed. You can do it throughout the day, the same thing. I've had a lot of acquaintances and patients saying, it just takes so long to get out. And I'm like, well, that's kind of the point, right? It's, we want this, I want to get it out really quickly, but I have to roll it. And it, I'm like, no, this is forcing me to slow down and watch this oil come out. One time the lighting in my room was just such that there was this massive shadow on the wall. And I saw the drop actually come out on this big shadow. And it was really neat, but it's just a beautiful, thick, viscous oil. So, and other things that vetiver can also help with is your immune system. It may help by taking it internally, and it can help in school for kids. So some people don't prefer the smell. Some kids don't, but this is a great place to put it on the bottom of their feet, on their brain points, on their heart and lung points, on the bottom of their feet to give them a little grounding. You can also do a little TLC with a vetiver essential oil bath. So combine it with some Epsom salts to help with grounding. So those are just some points that have been really it's fun to research, and I'm so thankful for this opportunity to be able to talk on this oil oasis, and I hope these are helpful for you, and thank you all for everything you do. Have a great day.
My name is Amy Carver, and I am a doTERRA Diamond with the company. I've been with doTERRA for a little over 6 years, and I am a licensed esthetician and makeup artist who specializes in organic skincare. Today, I'm going to talk about what does natural skincare mean. Natural skincare is actually ingredients already found in nature. They're free from any harmful chemicals, anything that is going to be toxic to our skin, to our bodies. Our skin is the largest organ that we have. It absorbs 60 to 70% of what we put on our skin. So it's very, very important that we take the time to look on the back of the bottles that we are using in our homes. So why natural beauty products? Why would you want to even choose that? Well, for me, what I've noticed in my treatment room, I have actually seen a lot of my clients have drawn more towards the natural because they have either gone down the route of using too many chemically induced and chemically laden products to where their skin is overly sensitive. It is very thin and crepey. It doesn't have that inner glow. It's got a lackluster effect. And they have just done way too much to it. The skin does not look strong. It doesn't look healthy. They've just kind of obliterated it to a certain extent. So they're turning to something natural to help build up the skin, to help nourish it and strengthen it. And that's why I love natural skincare, because you're not tearing things down. You're not scraping things down. You're not putting these aggressive peels. You're strengthening and embracing the skin that you were blessed with. So why natural beauty products? Why would you want to pick that? Because what happens, it's just like the oils. What happens when you use an oil on your skin? Your skin or your body internally goes, I recognize this. And that you'll see your skin goes, oh, I agree. We agree. This works great. And you'll see really good benefits from it. And that's why it's been so successful in my treatment room. So, let's see. What products does doTERRA have? This is a common question that people have asked me. What products and what skincare would you recommend, or what do they have available? The HD Clear line is really good for problematic and teenage skin more so. The Signature Essential Skincare line, their original skincare line, is my personal favorite. It's all in those silver bottles. They're really pretty, pearlescent silver bottles. I love them. It's great for all skin types. And then you also have the Virage, which is a newer skincare line we have had for just a few years now. And it's specific for anti-aging, and it's a little bit more aggressive than just our normal skincare line that we have, the essential skincare. So the cool thing is with skin is we go through different seasons, right? We have summer, spring, fall, winter. We change our wardrobes, right? Because we have different weathers and different, you know, environmental changes. Well, same thing with your skincare. You need to change it. Sometimes you need a little bit more hydration during fall or winter, or maybe you need to back off around the summertime so you can cycle through and put things away for a different season. Same thing with your wardrobe. You can kind of pick different things and add it into a different time of the year. Same thing with the skincare. If you like the Virage toner, add that in with the essential skincare line. I love mixing the products together. They work really well, but only you know your skin best. So I'm going to go over a few of my favorite products because I am obsessed with some of these and I want to share why. So first one is the hydrating cream, which actually has frankincense, jasmine, geranium, and lavender inside. Very, very good for dry aging skin. I use this year round. I love this. I used it on my pregnant belly to help nourish that stretching skin. I use it on not just my face, but on my neck and my décolleté. It's very, very good for hydrating skin. It's also not cakey. It's not like mayonnaise where some creams are too heavy. This one's very lightweight, but effective in penetrating deep into the skin. So I love this one. It's a fan favorite on our oil family team. We love, love, love this. Another one goes hand in hand with two products I'm actually going to talk about. So first one is the Reveal system. So if you do not know what the Reveal system is, you need to look it up and you need to grab it because this is something that stays, it's used. This is not brand new bottles. These are fresh from my shower. I use this all the time. What you have is you have the Reveal scrub, which is part one. So it's like a very fine scrub. And they're silk beads, and you scrub for about 2 minutes upward circular motions all throughout your face, your neck, and your décolleté. And then you put on the gel, which is a pumpkin enzyme, and you put that on top of the scrub. You don't wash the scrub off, okay? So you put that on, same thing, 2 minutes, all the way down, up. And what this does is an enzyme goes in and works like little Pac-Man and digests any dead skin cells that the scrub didn't get, any oil, dirt, debris, makeup that's lingered inside those pores, anything impacted. This really helps soften the skin and just takes anything else that kind of was lingering that the scrub didn't get. So I love these together. I used it today. I love this stuff. If you ever are going on a date, if you're going to be taking pictures, if you're going to be on a video, you are going to want to use the Reveal. It helps your makeup go on a lot better. I only use a powder, like a very thin powder, and a little bit of blush. I have no highlighter on right now because I believe taking care of your skin, that is the prettiest thing that you could wear instead of any other makeup that you could buy at any company. I love, love, love taking care of my skin. So you'll also notice a lot of YouTubers will be all about that matte face, right? Well, you ask any esthetician and they're all about that inner glow. Seeing that natural glow come out is so beautiful. It shows confidence. It's just, I love seeing the essence of you. So take care of that. I love, love, love the Reveal. But what goes with this is the brightening gel. I love the brightening gel, especially after using the Reveal, because now that we've taken off all of those little dead skin cells, any other layers that were lingering, you now have gotten rid of that unnecessary barrier for the brightening gel to go in and penetrate deeper into the skin. And the brightening gel actually has a micro encapsulated vitamin C. And what that does is it helps brighten and tighten the skin so that it can look a lot healthier and glow and be firmer. So vitamin C is a crucial anti-aging ingredient that you want in your skincare regimen. Another cool thing that the brightening gel has is daisy extract, which is also a brightener and a skin tightener. So it actually encourages cell turnover quicker so that you can see the effects of the brightening benefits faster than you would without it. So I absolutely love and adore this stuff. It goes on every single night. I put it on this morning. I love the feel of it. It's a gel. It's a very lightweight gel, and it does a really good job. So use those together. And then the last thing I want to go over is actually my little beauty hack, and it is the frankincense touch. I don't know if any of you are using this in your skincare, but I love this because it's in a touch roller. It's already pre-diluted, and I literally roll it all over my face, my neck, and my décolleté, and I rub it all in. It's the last thing to go on before my moisturizer, and it gives an instant glow to my skin. Frankincense, we know, are already really good for the cells. It's really good for emotions. It's really good for skin. It's the oil if you were, you know, if you only had one, right? Everyone would probably pick frankincense to keep. I love this because since it's in that base of coconut oil, it's ready to go on the skin. Our face is actually very sensitive, so you want to dilute the oils you put on your skin or add a drop into your moisturizer to use that as a carrier oil. This is awesome. I love this. So every time I use it, I look really good. My friends and family are like, dude, your skin looks great today. I'm like, oh, frankincense touch. But also, frankincense is really good for evening the skin tone. So any little age spots you have, you can use this in harmony with the brightening gel. You'll also see age spots, hyperpigmentation on the backs of your hands, sometimes from driving or just getting old. Aging just happens. But also around here, you'll see little spots around here. Sunscreen is a must, but frankincense and the brightening gel do a fantastic job in helping to make your skin a little bit more even, younger, and more youthful. All right, a few tips from me. Let your skin breathe. Wear less makeup. Like I said, take care of that skin. Nutrition is key. Make sure you're feeding your skin from within and then also using the right products on top externally. Let people see that skin shine through. It's the most beautiful thing. Another thing, wash your face morning and night. I love the Virage cleanser. It's one of my favorite cleansers. The essential skincare line, the facial cleanser, is also wonderful. Use either one of those. Don't use those makeup pads. That's not an effective way to wash your skin. So make sure you're washing morning and night. You will see an immediate difference. Another thing is to change your pillowcase. Change your pillowcase at least twice a week because you don't want to be laying in that stuff, especially if you're using hair products, any oils. You purge a lot. Your skin purges at night, actually. So you do a lot of rejuvenation during the night and healing. It's just what your natural body does. And you want to make sure that you are making a clean environment for that instead of creating something for problematic skin. And then the last thing, be consistent with your facial routines, with the oils, with the products. Be consistent. If you're wanting to help brighten your skin tone, use it every day. Don't use it once or twice a week. That's going to be how you see the biggest benefits, is be consistent. And then my theory is aging gracefully. I think embracing the beautiful skin you've been blessed with and just really being grateful for what you have, because you're beautiful.
All right. Hello, everyone. My name is Katie Glasgow, and I'm a blue diamond with doTERRA, and I live in a booming metropolis of about 4,000 people in Iowa, and this is where my family and I have settled because we love it, and it's beautiful out, and we love being around nature. We started our doTERRA journey when we lived in California, and so we started in California, and now we're in Iowa, and today I get the pleasure of talking to you a little bit more about natural products that we use on our body. Okay. So a lot of times when we start to think about the true picture of health, we automatically go to working out at the gym for a couple hours a day, or about the foods that we put in our body, or drinking enough water, or the mainstream thoughts around what does health look like, right? And those are
very, very important aspects that we need to look at in our health. But as I've just started to discover essential oils and started to use them more and more in my home and started to embrace more of a wellness lifestyle, I started to realize how big of an impact what we actually put on our body has in our health. Okay. So health is not just about eating right and exercising and things like that, but there's a lot of little things that we can be doing each and every day that are going to actually bump up our level of health. And so today we're going to dive into all the reasons that we need to be using natural products on our skin. And so the products that I'm going to be talking about, or the bigger term of the bigger group of stuff that I'm going to be talking about, is our lotions and our body sprays and our perfumes and our hair care and our skincare. This is all lumped into this category of what we need to be doing on a natural level. Okay. So I'm not going to talk a lot about skincare because we're going to have another expert come on and teach you more about skincare, but I want to focus on some of the body systems and the body parts that we're putting this stuff on. And especially as women, we need to be really looking out for this, because as women, we're putting so many products on our bodies each and every day. I think they say that the average woman puts over 25 products on her body before she even leaves the house in the morning. So I want you to start to think about shampoo, conditioner, anything you're using in the shower, any body wash. Are you using a lotion after you get out of the shower? Are you using a mask or anything like that? What kind of deodorant are you using? Are you using shampoos, hairsprays, all of those different all of those different products are affecting how we, our health in a big, big way. Okay. So first, before I get into some of the products, and I'm going to share some of my favorite DIYs in this area for you, I want to talk a little bit about why it's so important to actually put good products on our body. Okay. And so let's take a look at our body. And our body, our physical human body, is made in this most brilliant way. And it's made so that what we use and put on our body and in our body can dance in a certain way for our cells to come alive. And that's where that true picture of health comes from for us. Okay. And so what happens is we have built-in filtering systems in our body, okay? And some of those filtering systems are going to be through our GI tract, right? Through our intestine, the foods we eat. It's going to be through our urinary tract and eliminating through the bladder. And then we also have a couple of other built-in filtering systems, and that's our skin and our lungs, okay? And so these are, our bodies were made, because our bodies are just like this magic little bean that was made in the most perfect way. And our bodies were made to actually be able to filter out the toxins, okay? So what's happened though is modern society, the easy, we gotta smell good, we gotta look good type society, we've started to get into the point where our body cannot handle what we call our toxic load, okay? And so if you look at the doTERRA wellness lifestyle pyramid, you're going to see four levels up is reducing toxic load. And the reason for that is because our systems are just getting jammed. Okay. And if our systems are getting jammed and they can't flow in the right way, our body can't dance the way it's supposed to, and our cells can't be happy. We start to have a lot of health concerns and things like that. Okay. So skin is actually the largest filtering system of the entire body. Okay. So everything, it's meant to filter toxins out, but what happens if we're putting a bunch of stuff on it? It's actually absorbing like a little sponge. Okay. So dermal application of all of these products is going right into our system. Just like those essential oils are so effective to go in and give our bodies what we need, a lot of these products that we're using are clogging our system. It's not allowing our body to filter out the way it is. When I first started in this journey, it was about 8 years ago when I started and brought doTERRA into my home. And before that, I had always had a huge sensitivity with a lot of the products I was using and a lot of the different things I was using. Like I would get really red, irritated eyes when I used certain kinds of products. What I didn't understand at the time is that was just my body saying, hey, you're using something on me that does not like it, right? And that was because of those harmful chemicals that were in it. So we have to be really, really, really careful about what we're actually putting on our skin each and every single day. And women especially, because what's happening is we're using a lot more products than the guys. You know, they're just like, hey, I'm going to put some deodorant on and maybe some body spray or something like that. But women, we're putting a lot on. And a lot of this is because of these products that we're putting on our body just can't handle them. Okay. And so when we're looking for products, you guys, I hope, have gotten my point by now, but okay, we've got to be careful about what we're putting on our products, and it's really, really affecting our health, okay? And so when we're putting these products on, we start to look and we start to hear these buzzwords and we start to go down the rabbit hole of, okay, so what products do I actually need to use? What products do I need to avoid? What ingredients do I need to avoid? Okay. And so some of the ones that you're, the buzzwords that you're going to see are going to be like the sulfates, the parabens, anything that has a petroleum base to it. Because what a petroleum base does, which is in a lot of our natural lotions and not natural, but a lot of our lotions and things like that, that we're going to find in the big box retailers, those products actually have something that's like sealing up the skin. Okay. So if we need our skin to be a filtering organ, if we need the toxins to be able to come out, we don't want something that's going to clog those pores and clog the dermal layers of our skin. Okay. And so those are some of the products that you're going to be looking for, some of the keywords. But one of the things that I actually look for more than the actual ingredients is a company that I trust and a place that I can go to trust to find natural ingredients and natural products that I can feel confident using in my home. The consumer is now demanding more and more natural products. Okay. This is just the reality that we have going on right now because people are speaking up. People are starting to get educated. We're starting to see the consequences of these products that we might not have even seen 5 or 10 years ago. They're starting to link all of this information together. And so what we're seeing is the consumer is starting to demand, right? The education is getting out there. Well, then what starts to happen is that companies are like, hey, people aren't going to buy our products anymore because now they understand that we've got a bunch of stuff in them that the consumer doesn't want. And so they want to play the game too. They want to play the marketing game and they want to bring in some of these products. And they start to see, you're going to start to see commercials on TV of mainstream products. And they're like, we've got the natural version now. We're infused with essential oils. One of my favorite big box retailers, which is probably one of your favorite big box retailers, now has an entire section of natural products, right? They have Epsom salts that have essential oils in them. They have more natural face masks and different things like that. Well, I've actually looked at some of the ingredients on them and they're not any safer than the other ones. And so for me, I want a company that I can trust. I want to know that I can go to someone that it can explain it to me. If I do have a question on the ingredients, I'm going to have 100% transparency, which is what happens. If you have any questions on any doTERRA products, you email product@doTERRA.com. They're going to give you the explanation. You can't find that in many companies, right? If you go to a national brand company and you say, I have a question on this product, you're probably not going to hear back from customer support. And if you do, it's going to be a super canned answer. And so one of the things I love about using the natural products with doTERRA is that I know that without a doubt in my mind, the products that I'm using on my family are 100% natural and true. Okay. We all know by now, or maybe you don't know this, and I'm going to share this information with you now, is the essential oil industry is a lot of adulteration. It's a lot of dilution. It's a lot of adding in perfumes and scents and things like that. The more and more testing that we're doing through doTERRA and through the APARC is that we have more and more essential oils that are saying they're natural. They're saying they're 100% real. They're not real. And so if I have any product that's on the market that's not from doTERRA that says it has an essential oil in it, it's more than likely a fragrance-based essential oil. And it's no better than using any of the other counterparts. Okay. And so look for some of the key ingredients that you're not going to like, you know, those parabens, the sulfates, petroleum-based products, but also make sure that you're using that company that you know, love, and trust. And for me, that is definitely doTERRA. I've had this in my home for 8 years now, and I just cannot believe the results that I've had. One of the first products that I tried, because 8 years ago, we didn't have all the beautiful products that we have now, but one of the first ones I tried was our natural skincare. And immediately I fell in love with it, because even some of the other organic natural lines that I had tried still left me irritated and my skin gross, my eyeballs looking like I, big, bright and red and bulgy, which who wants to go around looking like that, right? And dry and itchy. And so the natural skincare was one of the first things I used, and I fell in love with it immediately. I had used many other different kinds of skincares prior to the doTERRA, and ever since I started using that, I have been on the skincare using the skincare since then. Okay. So today I want to talk a little bit about what we're going to put on our body and some tips that I have, and I'm going to incorporate some of the products that I have that I love to use to start to get us into this true state of health and getting our skin ready to go in a happy way. Okay. So I'm going to highlight just a little bit first, dry brushing with essential oils. Okay. And the reason I'm going to highlight this is because, if we are using some products that aren't so natural now, and we're starting to switch over to a natural wellness lifestyle, we want to be able to stimulate the skin and start to open up those pores, because they may be still clogged with some of those products. And we want to start to, stimulate, and we want to enhance our body's natural regulatory system, or our filtering organ of the skin. Okay. And so this is a dry brush. This is super simple. You can find these anywhere, and it doesn't matter where you find them. There's a dry brush is a dry brush. You don't have to be concerned about that. So this is the one I actually use for travel, because it's super easy to put in my hand. But the whole principle behind dry brushing is to really open up that dermal layer, to stimulate the lymphatic system, get that lymphatic system moving. And that, again, will start to, in turn, will start to help filter out all of anything that you have in your body, so that we can have that true state of health. Okay. My favorite essential oil to actually use when I am dry brushing is our pink pepper. Okay. So what I would do is I would just take the pink pepper. I would put 2 to 3 drops right on the dry brush. And then you're going to actually just take the dry brush, and you're going to go in a circular motion. Here, I'll put up my sleeve a little bit. And you're going to go in a circular motion on your skin. And you're going to do that all over your body, and you're going to go up toward your heart area. Okay. And so the goal of dry brushing is to go, and you're stimulating toward the heart, and getting everything in the body flowing. So you're going to do your legs, your arms, all of those different areas. I love using the pink pepper, because there's so many benefits with the pink pepper, especially women. I encourage you to do a little bit more research on pink pepper, ladies, because it is one that we need to be using on ourselves and in our bodies every single day. But you're just going to, the intention of dry brushing is just to go, I'm not going to do a whole demonstration on that, but I wanted to make sure you knew, because this is something I actually just learned not very long ago from Emily White, right? Is that you can put the essential oils on the dry brush to do your dry brushing. Okay. So again, we're stimulating the lymphatic system. Now, once we get that lymphatic system stimulated and we've got all of our pores open and we hop in a hot shower, are we going to want to put anything chemical and nasty on our body? No. So we need to start to pay attention to the products that we have in our shower. Okay. And so one of my favorites is our, and I didn't grab one to show you today, but one of ours is our body wash. Okay. We have body wash. We have natural soaps that you can use. Use something along those lines. My entire family uses it. Our body wash is super gentle. It's actually the one that my husband prefers over the bar soap. It's got a nice citrusy smell, so it's going to also get you invigorated and excited for the day and lift moods and emotions. But all the way from my 3-year-old all the way up to myself and my husband, we all use the body wash. That's another thing, is that it's all safe for the kiddos. And let me tell you, when it comes to kiddos, there are a lot of products on the market that are just not safe for kiddos. Okay. So you want to really pay attention to the kiddos. So ladies, this isn't just for you. Men, this isn't just for you. this is really important for the kids as well, to make sure that we're using these products. So make sure you're using that on your skin. We also have a body scrub that you could put over that, your skin. We're going into summer. We're going into wanting to be outside, wearing the shorts and the tank tops and things like that. That's going to help get your skin ready and glowing for summer too. Okay. Then when we pop out of the shower, we want to make sure that we're putting on lotions that are really good for us. So I'm going to tell you all right now that I'm kind of like the in-between DIY girl. I like to do some stuff on DIY, but I'm a busy mama. I got a lot going on. Sometimes I don't have time for the full-on DIY. So if you want tons of DIY recipes, just hop on over to the doTERRA blog because there are lots over there that you can explore. But my favorite when I get out of the bathtub is, or the shower, is the body mist. So if you have not tried the body mist, you want to try the body mist. It's super easy to use. I actually put a few squirts on and then I follow it with the spa lotion. Okay. And our spa lotion is completely unscented, right? So if you don't like scents, you can take this and you can add different essential oils into it. So you could pop in, you could put some balance, you could put some serenity. Maybe you want to do some slim and sassy because you really want to invigorate yourselves. My favorite to actually pair with this is aroma touch oil, okay? Because aroma touch is really invigorating. It's got cypress in it. It's the oil of movement and flow. Marjoram. It's also got basil. So if you have any types of fatigue stuff going on, the basil is renewing and energizing. I love putting the aroma touch in with this. That's my favorite combo. But you get the beautiful going on, you get this with the aroma touch, and you feel like you have gone to the spa every single day. Because that's another point I'm going to make, is that a lot of us, we think that we have to go somewhere to pamper ourselves. And I know when I do use all of this with doTERRA, I feel like I'm pampering myself every single day and treating myself like a queen, because I am with all these beautiful products we have. I remember the first time I had doTERRA in my home for a couple of months and my sister came to visit and she took a shower and she came out of the bathtub and she's like, oh my gosh, I feel like I was just at the spa. And it's so true, because the products smell wonderful. They're like a spa, and we don't have to go to the spa every day to experience that feeling. We can just use doTERRA in our home. All right. So I'm going to give you guys two more DIYs, because we got to talk about different things that we got going on. Now, I know, ladies, it's summer. And well, maybe you're not watching this when it's summer, but we're going into summer months. And a lot of us as women, we like to make sure our nails and our toes look really well, good, right? Here's the dealio. A lot of those places that you're going to get your nails and your toes done have a lot of ick going on in them. They're using a lot of products that are actually hurting our nail health and our skin health when it comes to what you're putting on your nails. So if you're getting manicures on a regular basis, the nail polishes, all of those things are really affecting our nail health. And so about a year ago, I decided that I wasn't going to do that anymore, that it just wasn't for me anymore. And, not only did I want to save some money, I also, because it, you know what, if you want to save some money, this is a great way, a great little ditty I'm going to share with you. But I wanted most importantly, I wanted my nails and my toenails to look better. Right. But I didn't want to, be putting all the harmful chemicals on them. And so I have this little tip. So this is Immortelle. Okay. So this oil is so beautiful and so exquisite, and it has all of those beautiful things in it, like heliochrism and sandalwood and so much goodness in this little bottle. And it is made as part of our skincare line, and it's the anti-aging oil. So it's really meant to go around the eyes, but there's so many other uses for it. And so what I do is I actually figured out that you could take this Immortelle. And now if I'm using it around my eyes, I'm going to keep it at full dilution because of all the power it has for around the eyes. But when I'm using it for other areas of my body, I actually dilute it down. And so I take one of these bottles and I make three of these. And so this empty roller bottle you can get in the DIY store on your doTERRA account. And I love these because they've got the steel roller bottles that are patented from doTERRA. And I love, love, love this delivery system. It's not going to leak all over. So I'm going to put one third of this bottle into here. And then I dilute it down with the fractionated coconut oil. Okay. And so, and then I'll just put like a little label on it, or you can just put like one of your little stickers from doTERRA on. And I have this ready to go. And I use this for my nails, my nail beds, and my cuticles. Okay. And so I'll take this. This one is actually already diluted down. And I'll just put it on my nails super quick like that. And I'll rub it in. And I do this every night before I go to bed. It's just part of my evening ritual. Okay. I do that and I will put it on my toenails as well. And I'll put it on my heels. So because we want to make sure we don't have calloused heels and things like that. We want to have our little pretty feet for summer. And I'll put it on my heels as well. And then I follow it with the doTERRA spa butter. Okay. And so this is our spa butter. If you've never had this, it's so exquisite and wonderful. You just need a little bit, and then you can put that on your feet. You can use it on your hands.